I remember she
bridge the distance created by Chet. To get again, so in different words, the concept of tshuva is to become closer to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That's why, there's no end to closeness to the Baruch Hashem. That's why the concept of tshuva is not necessarily applying to Chet. If a person thinks that he has, outside of that he has another problem, person thinks he has nothing to do tshuva on, he has a problem. But basically, he's making another mistake. He's making one mistake as a good, because it means he's so far away and so much doesn't feel that he has no self awareness whatsoever, that he's really in trouble. Like it says in the pasuk, "Hineini nishpat al imlach loy chatosi." You shake at you in this itself if you say loy chatosi that you didn't sin. But outside of that, he has a misunderstanding, even if it would be true that he doesn't have chatayim halavai, there's still a concept of tshuva. Because tshuva means to get closer to Hashem, to become more aware of the presence of the Creator in one's life. And that applies to everybody. Because to that, there's no end of levels of getting closer to Hashem. But this is belief so. Now, to go back to the subject. So we have a bracha every day. We ask Hashem to help us do tshuva. Where's this bracha? It ends in the Shmoneh Esrei. Baruch atah Hashem ha'rotze b'tshuva. He wants us to do tshuva. He waits for us to return to Him, to get close to Him. This is His deepest wish. We might say like this. Everything that we can get, we're mispalel to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is also mitpalel. He's something that HaKadosh Baruch Hu can't get, and he's mispalel in a certain sense. What's the tefillah of HaKadosh Baruch Hu? That we do tshuva, because HaKol Bidei Shemayim, everything is the hands of Shem, Hashem. Only one thing isn't the hands of Hashem. Ar Yir HaShemayim. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu waits on him, he's mishtoikeh, that we should have improved Ar Yir HaShemayim. Now this bracha begins with a different subject of Chayim. Hashiveinu Avinu L'Teira Secha, return us to your Torah. So now we have a Rambam. There is one mitzvah in the 630 mitzvahs called Talmud Torah, the study of Torah. There's another mitzvah called doing tshuva. Now what is the subject of this bracha? Is the subject Torah or is the subject tshuva? Which one is it? Why don't we end the bracha? If we begin the bracha, Hashiveinu Avinu Teresecha, maybe we should end the bracha. Baruch Ata Hashem, Aroitze V'Lam, Aboiche V'Am, Teres Am Yisrael. Something like that. Aroitze V'Lam, Shiyu V'Du Teres. We end it, we begin, we turn us to your Teres, and we end the bracha, you bring us, you want us to do tshuva. This tells us a certain piece of information which we might not be aware of. There's a language in the Zohar. Now that we define that tshuva is to get close to Hashem, let's see, is it possible to do tshuva without adding the study of Torah? It says like this, the Zohar says like this, Man dekoriv la'araisa koriv l'kutcha brichu. The person that's close to Torah is close to Hashem. Man de rochit me araise, rochit me kutcha brichu. You can't, this tells us a fantastic principle. A person in his own inventive mind and imagination can invent all sorts of ways of getting close to Hashem. And perhaps if he doesn't like to learn, if he's not such a good scholar, the last thing he'll think about is going sitting in the Beis Medrash. Maybe he'll run to Kvarim, go to Uman, excuse me for the Rav Nachman Breslev. So I'm not saying it's not a fine thing, I'm not canceling anything out, but you know, it can take a lot of time out of the Beis Medrash. The Beis Medrash will be on his list for doing tshuva, the last thing. He'll go to Ezer Rav or something, ask for some schoolers, some tikkunim, a lot of tilim. But it says here, not like that. The first step, this is what this bracha is saying. The first step, the tshuva, is to sit in the Beis Medrash. Hashiveinu avinu tersecha. Aye, it's difficult to learn. It's even a greater step of tshuva. The Tutsara Adra, the main mitzvah of Teira, in the Chukaisai Teirechu. What's the Chukaisai Teirechu? Shetiyu, Rashi says, Shetiyu ameilim b'teira, that you should toil and put effort into Teira. That means there is no greater tool to approach HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to get close to Hashem. The first step in getting closer to Hashem is to sit down, tipshutai, open up the Gemara, and become aware of how difficult it is to learn a Gemara. Get a chavusa, get a teacher, and break your head. The more you break your head to understand the Gemara, each one at his level, to try to get to a higher level of understanding, this is getting close to Hashem. That this foundational yisod, this, and this is the beginning of tshuva. Without the first step to tshuva is to increase nimin ha-teiru. That's the explanation of this bracha. Hashiveinu avinu teirosecha, return me to your Torah. Well, if I want to do tshuva, I have to first ask Hashem to return me to the study of Torah. Because without the study of Torah, there can't be a proper tshuva. To the amount that I'm close to Torah, so I'm close to Hashem. To the amount that I'm far away from Torah, so I'm far away from Hashem. So the answer to our question is, what's the subject of this bracha? The answer is, the subject of the bracha every day, we ask Hashem to help us do tshuva. But how does one do tshuva? What is the first step to do tshuva? Hashiveinu avinu l'teirasecha, to return to Torah. I always say, over in Chodesh Elul, so happy, because this is the first step to tshuva, so it's brought down that the students of Rabbi Yisrael Salanta would learn in the month of Elul 18 hours a day. We should learn each one according to his level. If you can sit for an hour without getting up from the book and not talking anything else, it's already a big thing. Each one hour, something else, 2 hours. They say Rav Elia Lapian had a Seder every day, 6 hours without any hefsek. 6 hours without hefsek. Each one according, but at least what is the message lema aser over here? That Chodesh El, you have to, each one according to his level, add to his study and toil of Torah. Whether it's in depth, but no contradiction, whether it's in time and continuity, to add time and effort in the study of Torah. Where should this study of Torah be? Not, of course, in the privacy of one house is a good thing too. But if you can't compare it, the study of Torah, when you're sitting in a Beis Medrash, or when you're sitting at the comfort of your home. It's different. And if you have a chavrusa, then it's even a different thing. The study, in other words, the greatest tikkun, so to speak, to help a person to change, to get feelings of kedusha and closeness to Hashem, is the study of Gemara with a chavrusa. Each one at his level. Now, getting back to the students of Rabbi Yisrael Salanta that they took upon themselves to learn 18 hours a day. We have in the Siddur. The Siddur, it's written like this. Eilu dvorim she'ein lahem shibur. After we make the bracha on the table. Ha'peyah v'abikurim v'yoyin. Gemilas chasodim v'sam l'peyah. I always say this over. It was the Shagas Aryeh. He wrote the Pevish. On the Zahas Hagiga. This mission of his price is brought down. And he says that you can make a mistake in this braisa, because the beginning of the braisa and the end of the braisa, the words ein lo shi'ur, they don't have an amount, the meaning changes. Why? When we say peya doesn't have an amount, Hey, what's the mitzvah pay? When somebody has a field, and they were aniyim, so they couldn't, there's allowed not to cut everything up, to leave something over when he's cutting the crop, to leave a corner for the aniyim, for the poor people. How much do you have to leave? He doesn't say anything. Don't cut everything. He left something, he fulfilled the mitzvah. How much can you leave? Ain't no shiur. No, he left. If he left 100, he fulfilled the mitzvah. He left a 50th, it's even more. He left a 10th. Oh, beautiful. Etc., etc., etc. Ain't no shiur. It means if you did a little bit, you did more, kavaya lecha bracha. You get a bigger bracha. What about gemilas chasod in the Talmud Torah? What are we going to say over here? For the day, you did more. Hey, you can get a bracha. You got to learn a piece of Torah for the day. Learn one pasuk a day. A pasuk a day keeps the doctor away. That's it. You did more. You get a bracha. Chas v'sholom. This is a wrong interpretation of this price. What is the minimum chiyuv of chesed and Torah? What's the obligation that the Torah wants? The answer is how much you can. Ain't no shiur. It doesn't have a shiur. You never cut them. You can't say I fulfilled the minimum quota. Now I'm free. It's an extra credit. There's no extra credit in Torah, and there's no extra credit in Chesed. If you can, that's your obligation. The obligation is ain't no shiur. That's the chiyuv. The chiyuv is ain't no shiur. It's a very important point. How much you're capable of learning, this is your obligation to learn. And if you don't fulfill your personal quota, then it's an aveira bitul Torah. Just like it says at the end of this braisa, Talmud Torah keneged kulam, the study of Torah is worth all the mitzvahs. The Talmud Yerushalmi says about this, kol chafotzecho lo yishvu bo, there's a pasuk. So it says, it doesn't say all the chafotzim, all the objects in this world. Dover HaMachs, kol chafotzecho, all your objects. What are the objects of Hashem? The mitzvahs. So it says, all the mitzvahs that a person can do are not equal to one thing of Torah. Torah has a power of closeness to Hashem and reward in the world to come more than all the mitzvahs. What does the Yetzer Hara do? The Yetzer Hara, when it's hard for a person to learn, the Yetzer Hara, if a person wants already to go to the Beis Medrash, if he doesn't want to go to the Beis Medrash, the Yetzer Hara will try to get him to do other things. If he's already holding on a bigger madrig and wants to go to the Beis Medrash, the Yetzer Hara will invent all sorts of mitzvahs that he has to do, all sorts of obligations, why not to go to the Beis Medrash? Because he's a businessman. You can't get him in Aveir, at least to get him in Bitul Torah, get him to do other mitzvahs. So one has to know, this is the Chiyuv. Now, the question is, so we have to understand, the students are very socialized. What does it mean that they learned more in Chai V'Shalom? Now we have a basic problem. What does it mean that they learned more in Chai V'Shalom than the rest of the year? What's going on here? If they could learn 18 hours a day, how come they didn't learn the whole year 18 hours a day? And if they can't, because if they could learn, so that's their obligation. So what's this big tzitkis that they learned 18 hours a day? And it means the rest of the year they had an Aveira, Bitul Torah. Oh, so what does it mean? And in Elul, they were makbid not to have the Aveira Bitul Torah. The whole year they had Aveira Bitul Torah. Can't be. On the other hand, if they couldn't learn 18 hours a day, so how come in Elul they learned 18 hours a day? Make up your mind. It's not a game. You have to do what you can. And by the way, this means that the chiyuv of learning of Torah is elastic. It's relative to each individual person, according to how Hashem made them in a situation in life. Each one has a different situation. In his own life, he has a different situation at different times. The answer is with a mashal. The answer to this question is with a mashal. What's the mashal? Bilam, the mashal is learned from Bilam. Bilam didn't have a power to curse, but the Gemara says he did. He had one special talent. What was the special talent of Bilam? That there's a Bilam knew to concentrate din, the meat of stern judgment on a person. How could he concentrate the meat of din on a person? Because there was a rega, ki rega ba'apo, like it says in the pasuk. There's a certain moment that a Kodesh Baruch Hu is koyes, because it's a marshal, but the midas adin is shayla, it rules in this world. Yodea hoya Bilam, Bilam knew to be mechamnu the rega that Hashem is kais. And in that rega, he could be ma'ir kitrik, be maskil, he'd be maskil the avonot, the side of evil of the person, and would bring on him a punishment. And that's what Bilam wanted to do to Klal Yisrael. What did HaKadosh Baruch Hu do? Mo'ezem lo'izom Hashem. Hashem didn't bring the Midas Adin in that period when Bilam wanted to bring. He didn't bring the Midas Akas. What do we see from this? That not every time is the same. That time has its shefa, its hashpah in this world. There's different times in the world. When do we express this idea? You know that every day we speak about this concept that there's different times in the world. And what do we see? That what Bilam could do in one time, he couldn't do in another time. Now this is talking about Peronius. When do we say this? You know when we say it? In the first blessing, the first bracha of Ma'ariv. How do we say? Mishane itim u'machlif es hazmanim. HaKadosh Baruch Hu changes the times and he changes zman. Now every zman has its own properties and own hashpah, own influence of the world. And what can be done in one time can be done in another time. Now the Bilam, he knew to be mechaven, to find, to exact the time of din. Just like there's a time of din, there's a concept of eis rotzon. Where does the begin the Chodesh of Elul? Now begins a zman, it's a Rashi in Chumash, in Chazal. Rashi brings the Chazal. Moshe Rabbeinu says, after Am Yisrael did the Chet HaEgel, the snapple of Nei Hashem, Kayomim HaRishoyim. What's Kayomim HaRishoyim? He was Aboyim Yoyim in Hasina. The last Aboyim Yoyim. Moshe Rabbeinu went up to heaven, Rosh Chodesh Elul, and he came down 40 days later. When did he come down 40 days later? He came down on Yom Kippur with the second tablets. Then he had Hashem wrote on the tablets, the Kiddush was Yom Kippur. Now this whole era, this was Yimei Rotzei, meaning that Hashem accepted the tshuva of Am Yisrael on the Chet of the Golden Calf. And so it remained this period as man like Am Yisrael, the first generation of Am Yisrael, did tshuva on their karmic sin, which lowered their level of ruchnius, of spirituality, of the golden calf. And Hashem accepted their tshuva. So it remained, in this sense, this was such a correction that Hashem, we gave them the tablets, we gave them a connection with Torah. So it remains Zman of receiving the Torah. Here again we see Torah and Tshuva going hand in hand together. This is the period that Moshe Rabbeinu was 40 days in heaven to bring down an acquisition of the Torah fitting about Tshuva. And it's the whole 40 days. So it's called an Eis Ratzon. Like the first 40 days when he went up in heaven to receive the first tablets, where there was a Ratzon, there was a closeness of Hashem to Klal Yisrael, so these last days, because of the tshuva of Klal Yisrael, is an Eis Ratzon. If it's an Eis Ratzon, like we said, Ani Sfirasi Lecha Hashem, Eis Ratzon, and an Eis Ratzon, and at the time of Ratzon, there's a Shefa and there's a help from Hashem, which you can't do, which you can do another time. So this, here we get back to the answer. Elul being an Eis, because Kavu Chaim, if there's such a thing as an Eis Din, like Bilam could only do a klala at the right time. So sometimes there's a help of tshuva, which you can do tshuva in others, you can achieve a change in yourself in this time of the year, which you won't necessarily be able to accomplish in the rest of the year. So that's point number two. What we spoke thus far, and we go over, basically we said here, two. This is, we said, we can divide it up into many points. We spoke about, first of all, we defined what is tshuva. That tshuva is to bridge the gap, the distance created by chet, to get closer to Hashem. But tshuva is not necessarily on chet. Tshuva means to return to Hashem, to get closer to Hashem. Point number one. Point number two, through the blessing of Ashiveinu Avinu L'Teresecha, He brought the Zaya that the first step to tshuva is to improve the study of Torah. Point three, analyze the chiyuv of Torah. The chiyuv of Torah is ein lo shi'ur. Point four, that we have the kasha of the Talmid Rav Yisrael Salanter. So how come they learned, what does it mean that they learned more in Chodesh Elul? He answered it with the Yisoyim of definition of Neis Rotzel. But not all the times are not the same, and what you can do in one time, you can't do in another time. That's what we spoke first. Now, point five.
So the Talmidim didn't have as much clock to learn 18 hours a day the rest of the year.
Because it was an Neis Rotzel Hashem gave. Now, I heard somebody told me over a marshal for Rosh Hashanah Pinkus, it's a nice marshal, to appreciate that. Somebody says, I want to do tshuva, he says, but he says, I don't see that I can. I can't do it. So he says, a marshal, since I connect with the base, he says, a doctor was on duty, an emergency, and they told him, if there's too much pressure and everything, you have to call, we'll come to help. If you need help, we'll come and help you. And there was a night, it was a very busy night, and I'm going to give a busy to the man. And one person he didn't get to in time, the person was there. They made him a mishpat.
Masajaya?
It's a mushroom.
Oh, okay.
And it could be a Masajaya Gamke. Why not? Could be a Masajaya. And they made him a mishpat. So he said, what do you want from me? I'm only a human being. I'm not a malach. I did my best. I went from patient to patient. I couldn't get to everybody. Yes, but we told you that if you have an emergency case, you can't deal. It will add more power. We have some people standing on the side, doctors standing to help you. Why didn't you ask for help? So his answer wasn't answered. He was declared guilty. The same thing a person says, I have all these affairs I want to get rid of, and I want to do tshuva. Says, I can't do it. I've tried. The Yetzirah is so strong, I can't do it. Says, yes, but Hashem said, ask me. I want to help you. There's an answer. I'm ready to help you, but got to ask me. Like this tefillah, you have tefillah on Volim Gashmiim, there's even more. Every tefillah on Ruchnius is answered. Like Chachamim put in the Shemayin Esrei, Hashiveinu Avinu Teresecha. It's true from one aspect. Hakol bidei shemayim, chutz miira shemayim. True, the person has to do it on his own. He doesn't have to do it all on his own. Day afterwards, Hashem is ready to help him, even if he can't do anything on his own. He can be mispalo from Hashem. So the person has to ask from Hashem, and then he wants us to ask him. Ask him, help me improve my learning. Help me with whichever the problem I have with the Yetzirah. Help me change. He has to turn to Hashem. He doesn't have to do it all. If he thinks that he has to do it all by himself, then he can't do it. He has to know he doesn't have to do it all by himself. The Ribbono Shel Olam is ready to help him, but he has to ask. There's an address, there's a telephone number that's ready to give aid, but you have to use the telephone. This telephone is tiller to the baby. That's the point. And this special aid, this special siyata d'shmaya, is more than the whole year in Chodesh Elul. That's the Koyach of Chodesh. And here we'll go to the Dershi Rishumis to bring down. Dershi Rishumis, Ani, the Elul, the Chachamim, the Meramis, Chodesh Elul, in many different places. The first place is the Pasuk in Shir HaShirim, Ani, the Doidi Li. The person has to awaken. Doidi is Miloshim from the language of Yididut, of friendship. A person, HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, Yidu Chatoyim, you become hated by Hashem, you become far from Hashem. But I'm ready to be a friend again. I'm waiting just that you should make friendship and make up with me. Come back and be one of my men. Anila Doidi v'datzelu. Anila Doidi, I'm to my friend and my friend is to me. Hashem is just waiting to recreate the friendship. Chodesh Elul is to create friendship with the Creator, with the Bari Oilim. Ani v'doidi v'doidi li. And how can this be done in Chodesh Elul? So now let's go to another remez, which is in the Torah itself. HaKadosh Baruch Hu says that Lasad Lavoi, when it's going to come the time of Mashiach, Umor Hashem Elokecha es levavcha v'slavav zareecha v'habes Hashem Elokecha v'chol levavcha v'chol nafshecha. It's in Parshas Nitzavim, I think. Umor Hashem Elokecha. V'achas hayomim v'shapter Hashem yedu tshuva. Just before Chamishi in Parshas Nitzavim, Umol Hashem Elokechas Levavcha, Hashem will circumcise your heart and the heart of your children. What does it mean? This, what would the circumcision of the heart be? Va'avas Hashem Elokecha, to love Hashem b'chol levavcha, with all your heart and with all your soul, l'man chayecha. What is the circumcision of the heart? So the Rambam, his explanation of the Torah. What does it mean that Hashem is going to circumcise the heart? We know a bris mila, we know the male cuts off a certain foreskin, but what does it mean? What's Hashem going to cut out of the heart? What's he going to cut from the heart? He says that's the, there's such a thing as oitem alei, that the heart doesn't feel. A person cannot feel. He doesn't sense the other one. He doesn't feel the basic truths. The circumcision of the heart, what prevents a person from feeling the basic truths? The yetzahar. The Milas HaLev is Hashem is going to take away from man the Yetzirah. And will take away because the Yetzirah is like an external force preventing a person from seeing the basic truths. And he's going to cut out this Yetzirah that's like the Chazal Seva and the Gemara Sukkot from the page 51, 52. As it says over there, La'asar HaKadosh Baruch Hu may be at the Yetzirah to shech them. He's going to shech the Yetzirah. That's this Milas HaLev. What does it have to do with Chedesh Shalom? Because the Baal HaTurim on this pasuk points out, Es levavcha, Umar Hashem alakecha, Es levavcha, ve'es levav. These four words, let's see the first letter of these four words. Es levavcha, so what's the first word? First letter? Aleph Lamed. Ve'es levav, Vav Lamed. Elu. That means, that every El awakens this Milas HaLev, Hashem, a little bit of the circumcision, what's going to be lost in Lavoi, that Hashem is going to uproot the Yetzirah totally, every El, this is awakened. And as the El progresses, there's the Siyat Nishmaya till Yom Kippur. How do we see that? Because what's Yom Kippur? Every, all El is a little bit of Yom Kippur. Yom Kippur is like the cold climax of the whole thing. It's concentrated. But all El is a mixus, has a mixus Yom Kippur. If you use the Elul properly, then the Yom Kippur can be Mechapa V'tshuva. How do we see that Yom Kippur has this concept? Because the Gemara says, the Yetzirah, one of the names of the Yetzirah is Hasatan. The famous Yetzirah, Hasatan. What is the gematria of Hasatan? The Gemara in Yuma Daf Tavala. What's Hasatan? Let's see, Hasatan. You know that every letter in Hebrew has a numerical value.
5, 400, 9.
Yeah, but Shin is not 5. Shin is 300.
Yeah.
So and Tess is 9 and Nun is 50. So we have 359 plus 5. Is how much does it come to altogether? 364. How many days are there in a solar year? 365. So say, why is it 364? Because the Sotan, the solar year, this under the Shemesh, the Sotan talks a person in to go that this world is something. To go and to be under the sun, to be connect himself with this whole physical world, which Olam Hazeh. But there's one day a year that the sun doesn't have power. That the Yidden are totally tied up with the, they feel and sense the Emunah that this world is nothing, and that the main thing in life is to just prepare for Olam Habor. What's that day? Yom Kippur. On Yom Kippur, the sun doesn't have a Shlita. So that's why the Gematria is 364, not 365. Because this one day the Sotan doesn't have Shlita on Yom Kippur. But that's Yom Kippur, but all El we see from this Baal HaTurim has a bit of this, is a bit of Yom Kippur. There's less the Yetzirah, a person goes on vacation, so he's in a different atmosphere. But Hashem sends the Yetzirah a little bit on vacation. A person's on a little bit of a vacation from the Yetzirah these days. He can accomplish different things because the Yetzirah is less powerful. He wants to connect. But of course, this is all such a thing as skulot. But you have to connect. You have to use the skulot. It has conditions. It's potentially there in the creation, but it's only if a person has a deep wish to change, a deep wish to change himself, deeply, to change his habits, to change his way of thinking. In other words, that's...
Yes. Everybody always says, I cannot try hard enough. It's true, right? Results do...
No, but it could be true, it could be not true. Maybe you're trying hard enough, but maybe you'd have to use different methods. For example, tefillah. Maybe you're doing the best you can without the help of Hashem, so to try to ask Hashem to help you. Or ask Hashem to show you different methods. You might be trying mamish your maximum, but you have to do it the right way. And so maybe it needs Hashem to open your eyes to use, you're not doing the right methods.
It's like the gears of the car. You're pressing them down on the gas, almost the whole thing, but you're in second gear. There's only so much you can do.
There's only so much you can do in such a situation. For example, a person goes every day, puts himself in a certain situation where he's in a place where there's no Yirat Shamayim, no Kedusha, and he doesn't want to go to the Beis Medrash. He says, but Hashem, help me, I'm trying my best. Yeah, in this situation, you can't do more than that. But who says you should be in this situation? Maybe you have to put yourself in another situation. So this is another Eitzah for Chodesh Elul. Because since a person is greatly influenced, like Rambam says, about his surroundings, so the biggest, that's where here we get again. Arba Midas, we spoke about before about learning. Even if you can't learn so much, maybe put yourself out as a Beis Medrash. Without learning. And the more you're in a Beis Medrash, or a Beis HaKnesses, the surroundings of a Beis Medrash, just like the surroundings of a place, if you put yourself in the marketplace, this has one type of hashpah. You put yourself in a Beis Medrash, it has a different hashpah. It's not in the hands of a person when he's in a certain surroundings to overcome the hashpah of that surroundings. But it is in the hands of a person to choose which surroundings he's going to put himself in. That's in the hands. So sometimes a person is in situations, I'm doing the maximum, I can't do better. Yes, but it might be because one of his choices before is wrong. He might be in the given situation doing his maximum, but maybe he shouldn't be in that situation. Maybe he should have chose to be in another situation, and that he had free will to put himself in a different situation. The kids, so we spoke many, many different things about Chodesh Elul. Now another point, I'll just end with that. So we spoke two Ramazim of Elul. I need a baby to go lead, and I say, Mal Hashem HaKetz HaBach HaZrach. So that was another important point, because all this is connected with Beinodim Lamokim, which is of course the Iker, but we also have to be Mahadir and Beinodim Chaveirim. And where is it hinted to? No less than Megillas Esther. We have the mitzvah in Purim, Mishvoyach Monis, Ish L'Rei Eyu, and Atonis L'Adyoyim. Let's analyze what's Ish L'Rei Eyu. Ish L'Rei Eyu means the way you look at the other person, he looks at you. If you look at the other person with love, he'll love you too. Ish L'Rei Eyu, he mirrors what you are. Now, Ish u'matonus l'vyoinim is to help the needy. Look at the first letters of these four words. Ish l'reyeyu, what's the first letter of these two words?
Aleph
lamed. U'matonus l'vyoinim. Vav lamed. Elo, we have to improve as well. Ish l'reyeyu, matonus l'vyoinim. So we spoke now three remozim. There's many more in the Torah. But there's three remozim of Chodesh Elo would give us the message what we have to be working on. Ani l'doidi l'doidi li, that to awaken the tshuva to get close to Hashem. Mol Hashem es levochus levav zerecha, to believe that there's a special tziyat v'shmai in Chodesh Shalom, and has to use that, and then he gets that tziyat v'shmai to tune in with the koyach of tzvila, and to improve in as well, in the best Lashon Hara, in the Nevi L'mur Chesed, Ish re'eyu matonis levim.
אל תירא מפחד פיסוי ומשויס רשויים משויס רשויים כי סובוי אל תירא